military operations can be compared with the game of chess. The foot soldiers, like pawns, are able to move only step by step, while the more powerful chess pieces have mobility and move more swiftly, striking from a distance like tanks or artillery. In combat, fast maneuvering can be decisive, with victory often going to the side which can most quickly apply the greatest concentration of power against a critical position. Military strategists, experienced in the utilization of air power, now explore further application of the airplane to supply greater mobility for ground force activities. In a factory in Southern California, a huge airplane has been developed. This giant transport was designed and built by the Douglas Aircraft Company for the United States Air Force. Designated the C-124 Globemaster, it flew for the first time in November of 1949. With a capacity of more than 25 tons of payload, the Globemaster could transport troops, litter patients, major items of equipment, or general cargo. Hundreds of them rolled off the production lines to carry out missions all over the globe. The Air Force felt confident that the solution to the ground force's need for increased mobility might be found in these mighty transports. But there were questions in the minds of military strategists which only actual tests could answer. Could a squadron of C-124s move a fully equipped airborne division, deliver it ready for immediate action, and then return to base? How fast could these airplanes be loaded and unloaded for such a maneuver? Would it be possible to maintain the close formation required at speed slow enough to safely drop paratroops and equipment in a concentrated pattern on a designated drop zone? Acting in cooperation with Test Board Number 1 of the Army's Field Forces, the 62nd Troop Carrier Wing of the 18th Air Force moves to supply the answers. These are the airplanes. These are the men who will fly them. In an intensive briefing session, the first test is detailed. Plans call for 9 airplanes to drop 360,000 pounds of cargo in a matter of seconds, and with such precision that it will land in a concentrated area on the drop zone. The Globemasters are swiftly loaded for the test with especially packaged bundles weighing 2,000 pounds each. For a combat mission, the cargo would consist of food, ammunition, fuel, and other material required to supply an attacking force in a forward area. 20 bundles are put aboard each airplane, their weight totaling 40,000 pounds, in addition to the parachutes which will float them to the ground. Everything is ready for the big test. The airplanes taxi into position for takeoff. Despite their size, the C-124s lift off the runway at regular 10-second intervals. When they are airborne, the airplanes move into formation. Behind simulated enemy lines, a Pathfinder crew, dropped by an earlier airplane, marks the drop zone. The signal is in the form of a giant T. The formation commander sets the course. The other C-124s form up behind. The great transports, carrying enormous burdens, hold tight formation, flying high or flying low, in a V or in a line. With the formation only 4 minutes away, the Pathfinder group burns a yellow alert flare. The C-124s approach the drop zone. It's a critical moment for the pilots. C-124 success of the entire operation depends on split-second timing. The formation commander in the lead plane must hold an exact position at precisely the correct speed. The first bundle falling from his plane will signal the start of the mass drop. Tensed observers watch for the first chute to puff from the lead airplane. There it is. And there go the others. Each airplane releases its cargo in from 6 to 12 seconds. 360,000 pounds parachute earthward. The first bundle lands right on target. The others follow, all falling well within the prescribed area. The cargo drop test is successful. But the big test, parachuting large masses of airborne fighting men into a forward area, is yet to come. More than 1,000 officers and men of the 82nd Airborne Division are ready to put the new tactical and strategic concept to a test. For this operation, each C-124 is loaded with 112 troops carrying full field equipment, or an alternate combination of 88 men and 6 2,000-pound supply containers. The airplanes take off. Operational problems are compounded. Formations must be even more precise to ensure maximum safety for the men. Jump requirements fix the speed of the air giants at 130 knots over the drop zone. The C-124s hold their positions perfectly. Once more, the alert signal flares at the site of ground operations. As the formation approaches the drop zone, the expertly trained paratroopers prepare to jump. The men await the jump master's signal. The green light flashes on, the drop begins. 112 men, 56 pouring from each side of the lead airplane, hit the silk at less than a 1 second interval. The others exit from the following planes, and the sky is suddenly filled with parachutes. This is the greatest mass jump in history. Down come the precision drop paratroops. They land in a pre-planned pattern in the area prescribed. With parachutes collapsed and harnesses unfastened, men are ready for ground action. airborne troops establishing an airhead, prepared to strike at an enemy weak point, to apply pressure when and where it is least expected, a concentration of power at the right place at the right time. Exercise Test Drop has demonstrated to military strategists the practicability of delivering troops, supplies, and materiel by air to forward combat positions. The speed and mobility essential to successful ground force operations can now be supplied by the C-124 Globemaster, winged giant of the Air Force. In a factory in Southern California, a huge airplane has been developed. This giant transport was designed and built by the Douglas Aircraft Company for the United States Air Force. Designated the C-124 Globemaster, it flew for the first time in November of 1949. Military operations can be compared with the game of chess. The foot soldiers, like pawns, are able to move only step by step, while the more powerful chess pieces have mobility, can move more swiftly, striking from a distance like tanks or artillery. With a capacity of more than 25 tons of payload, the Globemaster could transport troops, litter patients, major items of equipment, or general cargo. Hundreds of them rolled off the production lines to carry out missions all over the globe. The Air Force felt confident that the solution to the ground forces. In combat, fast maneuvering can be decisive, with victory often going to the side which can most quickly apply the greatest concentration of power against a critical position. Military strategists, experienced in the utilization of air power, now explore further application of the airplane to supply greater mobility for ground force.